Let's sing together this morning. Intro. So we're going to teach it to you. Notice on the second line it says clap. What are you supposed to do at that point? Let's see if we can do that. Ready? All right, we're good. And so that is, you're going to walk into the closet and shut the door. Let's try that one more time. You're going to walk into the closet and shut the door. We'll sing it through a couple of times, and then we're going to stop and think about what it means. And we'll sing it one last time. You gotta walk into the closet and shut the door to communicate with the Lord. You gotta tell him all your troubles, your cares, your woes, enumerate with the Lord. Whatever you tell him in secret, to get his attention or to get someone else's attention to convince them that we're talking to God, that it's private, it's personal. God actually wants to be private and personal with us. He wants our hearts to touch his hearts, his heart. And our heart changes in the process. We end up understanding more about what's in his heart through the act of contemplation and prayer. And then, that's why it is that whatever you tell him in secret, he'll openly reward, because our minds come together with God's mind. We're praying according to his will, and we want the same thing that he wants, and he's going to give it to us because we prayed for it and because we came together with him. Isn't it kind of cool that God wants that kind of intimacy with us? Let's try it one more time. You've got to walk into the closet and shut the door to communicate with the Lord. You've got to tell Him all your troubles, your cares, your woes, enumerate with the Lord. Whatever you tell Him in secret, He'll openly reward. You've got to walk into the closet and so I wonder if when, and during those private moments when we are connecting with God and our mind is coming together with His, I wonder if it ever causes us to think about other people. Does it ever cause us to think about those that God wants to shine His love to through us? Pass it on. It only takes a spark to get a fire going. All those around and warm up to its glowing. That's how. He's not only powerful and capable and just and fair, He's good.
Amen.
And His goodness touches every corner of our lives. And so as we sing this last song, I invite you to come forward for the Garden of Prayer. And we're going to pray through this song as well. And we're going to meditate on the goodness of God.